Hi guys, welcome back to another episode of Go Off Sis. I am Danielle.
I'm Cassidy.
And I'm Lexi.
It's good to be back. It is officially fall.
Happy September. I don't know, middle of September?
I don't know the date.
Fall?
Okay, yeah. The first day, day of fall is September 21st.
But today's the 23rd.
Right. I'm saying it's officially fall. Last time we recorded, it was summer. Yeah.
Oh.
All I'm saying.
We're recording this a little, batch, just so you guys know, since Lexi just revealed our recording date.
Oh.
We couldn't stay mysterious. So.
Sorry.
We did have to batch a few, but that's just, you know, mom life for Danielle.
I was never told to stay mysterious, so.
Right. Lexi has problems staying mysterious.
I actually don't. I feel like I'm good at being mysterious.
I actually do think she's mysterious.
Really?
Number one, she doesn't have a calendar. So things are always just
right,
wherever.
There.
If she shows up, incredible.
Because you know. I overshare and then I'm always like, shoot, I overshared. And then I stop.
Oh, I see.
And then I go into a mysterious mode.
Okay.
You know?
Okay. That's fair. Yeah. There are times where I feel like, wow, Lexi's being so mysterious right now. And then there are times where I'm like, wow, she's really going into detail.
Yeah. Depends on how much coffee I've had.
It's true.
And the time of day.
Yeah.
That's true. Really all.
The other day we were shopping and I noticed Lexi wasn't talking very much. And I was like, Lexi, everything good? And she was like, yeah, I'm just trying to not talk as much. And I was like, why? She was like, I don't know. I'm trying to be mysterious.
Nope.
10 minutes later, girl is yapping.
I don't even think I was yapping.
Lexi.
I do feel like probably once every month, maybe once every couple of weeks, Lexi has this realization that she needs to be more mysterious. And we're all like, okay, Lexi. So we give her a week or whatever to be silent. And then she's back.
Dude, I don't know what it is. I go into these weird mental things. I put my phone on do not disturb. I don't text. I just do my own thing. And then I randomly come back.
Yeah, it's like she wants to be a black cat.
I don't even try.
But
it's
she's
not
a
like
puppy
I plan
dog.
This.
Right.
Yeah.
I don't think I'm a puppy dog. Lindsay's a puppy dog.
I don't know.
Cassidy's definitely a cat.
Oh.
I don't know if you're a black cat.
Well, that's
though.
Nice.
Yeah. I mean, no, I'm not denying my
maybe a
cat
naked
energy.
Cat.
Oh, cool.
Oh.
I actually was thinking you're
a Siamese.
You're more like a rodent, I would say.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I was thinking guinea pig.
I think it's funny because I feel like everyone's favorite animal kind of relates to who they are. You like pigs.
Oh,
I feel
interesting. I literally was just waiting for you to say that.
I feel like you really embody that. You know what I mean?
What's your favorite animal?
A penguin. Oh. I feel like I give penguin a little cute penguin. You know?
I'm not ready for that.
And then I think Lindsay gives a puppies, a little puppy dog.
Right.
And what's your favorite animal?
Appa.
It used to be a bunny, one of those cute bunnies.
Mm-hmm.
What?
Yeah.
I thought you liked pandas, or was it koalas?
Oh, pandas was my hyperfixation for a long
they're
time.
They're going extinct.
Okay.
Oh.
Mm. Cool.
That's sad.
Well, pigs get slaughtered every day, Danielle.
Oh. Well, if you're listening, please go donate to the panda fund so they don't go extinct.
Yes.
Did you see recently that zoo in China is being sued because they just made dogs, they dyed dogs' hair and made them look like pandas and were telling people that they were pandas.
How do you even make a dog look like a panda?
Dude, look it up. Look up Chinese panda zoo dogs.
No, listen to this. Did you guys hear about the penguin that was born in the Australian zoo?
No.
What?
It was born and its name is Pesto. It is huge.
Oh.
A mammoth of a penguin. And it's kind of a gray color. The rest of them are black and white. Hmm. It's a huge gray penguin. And it's a brand new young penguin. It's bigger than all the other penguins.
I wonder if it's
mutant.
Yeah, or got crossed with something.
I don't know. Yeah, mama's got some explaining to do.
Yeah, for real. You know, have you guys seen that little hippo, Moomin or whatever?
Yeah.
I haven't. No.
Oh, he's really, he's blown up. I see him all the time on TikTok. He's just a little hippo. Everyone loves him.
That's cute.
That's really it. Yeah. But, okay, so what were we talking about? What was the
you
point
brought
of
up
this?
The animals.
I don't remember. Oh, we were talking about me being mysterious.
Yeah.
And then somehow we got into
And
animals.
Then you said that we represent our favorite animals.
Right.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah.
So this episode, we're playing a fun game. Mm-hmm. I don't even know what the game is called.
It is called I Should Have Known That.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So
a trivia game about things you ought to know.
Brought to you by Lexi.
Yes.
She did Venmo request us. for this game.
First of all, it was your guys' suggestion. You said buy it and I'll Venmo. And I was like, okay, period.
Yeah.
But I found it in South Carolina at a Walmart and sent it and was like, we should play this.
Because I know all the listeners love hearing when we're
stupid.
A little bit on the stupid side.
Idiotic. So,
Yeah.
We just have our strengths.
We do.
Mm-hmm.
Chatting is one of them.
Mm-hmm.
Knowing the capital of China is not one of them.
Oh, my word.
You knew it.
I got
it right.
I did. Yeah. I don't know. One of you said Tokyo. The other one said...
Lexi did.
I didn't say Tokyo. I know Tokyo is the capital of Japan. Or is...
she... Yeah, see, she's done.
Or is it
know.
A different country?
Okay.
No, it is the capital of Japan.
Okay.
Yeah.
I just get confused because you say you want to go to Tokyo and then sometimes you say Japan and I'm like, oh crap, are those the same place? And then I just get nervous.
And then she becomes mysterious.
And then I just don't talk for 30 minutes.
So we wanted to start the episode with our segments.
Oh,
we haven't done this in a minute. Who wants to go first?
I can. So mine is just like a crazy story. This one happened to me like a few weeks ago. It was like a Sunday. Okay. So trigger warning, scary. Okay.
Oh my gosh.
So I like go to the gas station and I just finished watching the Dolphins football game at my parents and I go to the gas station kind of where they live, whatever. I pull up like this is a gas station I'm comfortable at, you know, like I went there all of high school. I literally see three people I know from high school. And I'm just like, I park by the, I don't know what it's called, gas.
The pump.
I was going to say the gas station. And I was like, no, that can't be right. So I park by the pump and I'm looking down like in my wallet to grab my card. And then I just like, look up to a knock on my window and it's like this woman and she's like skinny, like brown hair, really pretty smile. And she's like smiling at me, like literally the biggest smile you can imagine. I'm like, remember like Demi Lovato when she used to hit with that. Like that is what she's looking at me with. And I'm like, oh, okay. Like maybe she knows mom or something, you know? Right. So I was like, and she like waves and I'm like, hi. And then I roll down my window and I have to remember exactly what happened, but she basically looks at me and goes, hi, like God bless you. And I was like, oh, okay. Like, I guess that's nice. And I was like, oh, thank you. And like, while I'm in the middle of saying thank you, she's like, yeah, if you don't believe in Jesus, you're gonna go to hell.
Bye.
And then flips me off and walks away like strutting. Like, I don't know why she's strutting. Like, she thinks she just ate. And then she literally like keeps looking at me like from far away. And she's like waving at me like,
oh,
and then spits on the floor like towards me. And she never breaks eye contact with me. She grabs her bike and like looks at me. And the whole time she's like waving at me goodbye. Like,
what did you do to her?
Nothing. I didn't even see this woman. Like, that's she. I don't even know where she came from. I just pulled in. It was a normal day at the gas station. I don't know. And like, I was just like, first of all, you didn't even give me a second to like hold up my cross necklace and be like, listen, bro, I'm good. But don't tell me I'm gonna go to hell. Mm-hmm. Don't like,
no,
and don't
then
knock
spitting
my,
and
yeah.
then flipping and, you off. Like, what?
Yeah, it was like actually
so
crazy.
Strange.
It was so strange. I was like, I don't know. I mean, she was on a bike. She had a backpack. I don't really know. I don't know the vibe. But she looked like really normal. So it was like a really weird experience. It actually scared me a
that
lot.
That is really scary.
I'd
I was
be
like,
terrified.
Yeah. Because she like made sure she like never looked away from me. And I was like, did she go up to other cars and do this? Like, why only me?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. It's like she went out of her way. And that's different than like, hey, do you have money? Like, if someone's like asking you for money, like that's so normal where I feel like, that doesn't really like kind of ruin the rest of my day, but something like that would ruin
yeah,
like an attack on your character.
It. Yeah. It's like, I literally something. Like, you didn't even know me and you're like,
yeah.
Just knocking on my window. Like, I don't know.
I'm surprised you rolled down your window, but I mean, at that gas station,
yeah,
it's like,
yeah.
It could be mom's friend.
Oh my gosh. Exactly. And it wasn't late at night.
Yeah.
Like there was still sun up. There's so many people. Yeah. Like I said, I knew three other people at the gas station, so I wasn't like scared.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And also I was in my car. Yeah. So it was like low key. Like if she didn't, I literally just rolled my window back up.
Yeah.
Like, and then I didn't get gas there. I drove to a different one.
There was one time I was stopped at a stoplight near downtown and I like see this person like kind of like walking along the sidewalk and then they start crossing towards my car and they come right up to my window and they have their driver's license in their hand. They stick it up to the window and they're pointing at it and looking at me, pointing at their license so I could see their license. And literally they're doing that until the light turns green.
Why?
I have no idea.
That's so weird.
It's freaky.
It is freaky.
It's like, why are you doing
like,
this?
Yeah, like, yeah. Why me? Like, what am I, what did I do to you?
Literally, yeah, there's like five cars and I'm like, of course you choose the girl that's in the Prius. Yeah.
No, for real. I was just a girl in a Prius. I don't know. A girl in a Prius. It was hard because it was like, she was definitely very weird about it. But it was like, she spit when she walked away. So it wasn't like she like spit at me. So, but it felt like it was like, you don't just like spit on the floor and look at someone, but it was like from far away. And then like, she was doing a lot with her hands, but she'd like while making eye contact with me, but she was far away. So I couldn't see what she was doing with her hands.
Yeah.
So it was like a lot of like, I don't know what's even going on, but there's definitely something wrong.
Yeah. Yes. She's probably on.
I don't know. Yeah. I was just like, whatever. So I left.
That's weird.
That's my crazy story.
That's crazy.
That is a crazy. That's scary.
Wow. Yeah. After that, that's when mom got me that little birdie thing, I think.
I think so.
Oh, because, probably.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's terrifying. Wow.
Well, Danielle, you had a crazy story, you said, as well?
I do kind of have a crazy story. Okay. So it's more so I want to know your guys' opinion.
Oh, we're always somebody, ready to give an opinion.
I just want to know your opinion. So this is a real story. So basically there is this, how do I even start this? I like can't say names. Okay. There's this guy who is originally from this area and he, I mean, obviously, yeah, whatever. There's this guy, he's originally from this area, but he moved, with his wife a while ago out to another state.
So from here where we live?
Right.
Okay.
So this is actually a year ago that this happened, but things are, a year ago, somebody else, a girl here was on Tinder swiping and they see this guy's profile on Tinder.
Yep.
And he's married, like in a very, what appears like loving, committed relationship. This girl reaches out when she sees this profile, she like knows this guy and she reaches out to some of this guy's friends and says like, hey, like, did you see this? Like, this is kind of weird. Like, why?
So she reaches out to the guy's friends and asks?
Yeah, because she doesn't really know the guy super well, but she knows some of his friends.
Okay.
She was like, this is kind of weird. Like, what do you guys think is going on? And she took a screenshot of when she saw the profile, and then she went to go look for it again, and it like wasn't there anyways.
I was gonna say I wouldn't tell the guy's friends. She's gonna take it down.
Well, so
they'd be like, "You're caught."
Come to find out, and it was weird because this guy like doesn't live in this state, but it said he was in this area when she was on Tinder.
Okay.
Come to find out, they look at like when this girl took the screenshot of his profile. He was actually in town when she saw this profile on Tinder.
Okay.
So I'm trying to like figure out how to explain this really well. So the people that found out that are this guy's friend, they approach him and they say like, hey dude, like we care about you. You're a good friend. Like we care about you. We just want to know like what's up with this profile that this girl saw. They're like, we're here for you. We just want to give you an opportunity to like talk about why your profile's on Tinder.
Oh, okay.
So this guy, he says, hey, like, I'm so glad, like, you're a really good friend for approaching me. Like, but I actually had somebody when I was in Grand Rapids last hack my phone. They stole a bunch of photos off of my phone, and I guess they must have made this profile when I was home.
I knew he was going to say that.
He was like, I just feel really like angry and violated. Like, thank you so much for telling me this. And I was like, okay, well, I am not involved in this story at all, but I heard about this and I got permission to talk about it anonymously. I just want to know what you guys think when somebody says that somebody hacked their phone.
He's a liar.
Absolutely. I was like, what does that even mean? Well, hacked your phone.
Yeah, I think hacked the phone is definitely a lie. I have seen people where they take someone's identity and bring them on Tinder.
Oh, absolutely.
Like, I've had a few of my friends, like, someone has used pictures of them and literally their whole life story and gone on Tinder with it. So it's like, and absolutely. Then you're like, oh, that's not me.
Yeah, but it's photos from, like, social media or something.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
It's not, how do you hack someone's phone like that?
You
genuinely
don't.
Yeah.
Their you don't. iCloud?
That's what I'm saying. Like,
you have to have all their login info.
Hack your phone is a crazy thing to say. Yeah. If they would have said, like, hacked my Facebook or hacked my iCloud or something,
yeah,
that would make sense. But I was just like,
someone hacked
your
phone.
You're lying. You're literally lying.
Hacked,
also,
like, they hacked your phone and the thing they want to do is go on Tinder. When that, you're vacationing right. there, like, no, they're going to
steal
your money.
They don't want to steal your credit card info?
Yeah.
No, like, why do they want to...
Why do they want to go on Tinder
it's
as you?
It's too much in your favor to be on Tinder for that to make sense.
Yeah.
Right.
And also, like, that's something that, like, if you're going to cheat, you're going to go to a new location, you're going to create a profile while you're there because it only does that area.
Right.
Yeah. So
exactly.
You know, so, like, it makes sense why you would do that if that was your intention.
Here's what I would do. Go to his phone... Mm-hmm. Go to the Tinder app. You can see if he's ever downloaded it.
Exactly.
And see if he has like a saved password on there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Or literally whatever profile, like if it is someone that created a profile, like however, find that profile mm-hmm. and figure out like what email was used for that.
Mm-hmm.
Or like try to talk to that person and see what number they give you. Like,
oh yeah. Also, my friend was saying that Tinder now has like such intense like security measures so that you can't be a catfish, that a few days after creating your profile you have to do face ID with your photos.
And do you have to like give like your driver's license too, probably?
I don't know about that.
Do
I just
have
know
to
you have
for
to do
Venmo
maybe.
I don't know. Yeah, I think for Venmo.
Yeah.
But yeah, that's what David was saying, that like for Hinge, like they make you like scan your face.
Yeah.
Which makes sense.
Because my friend actually tried to create a fake profile to find this profile.
Oh.
And he didn't know about the face ID.
Yeah.
And so then they were asking for the face ID and then he got banned from Tinder.
Well, there you go.
That's
so
funny.
Don't try to catfish.
Okay, so that's crazy.
Yeah. Dude, that is crazy. It is crazy. I was just like...
I feel bad for the wife.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I do too. Yeah.
Does she know?
I think so.
Okay.
Who knows?
Isn't that what happened in the Secret Life of Mormon Wives show? One of guys was on Tinder.
Whitney's husband or whatever. Yeah. Uh-huh.
I feel like it happened. Like, I feel like it's really common.
Yeah.
Like, that's like one way I feel like a lot of women find out their significant other is cheating is their friends find them on Tinder.
Yeah. Well, a lot of
or
men
like
think
Hinge. I don't actually know anyone that uses Tinder.
A lot of men think that like their circle will never find out because their circle is not on Tinder. They're like, oh, all of our friends are married. Nobody's going to find out.
Right.
But it's like, dude, it's Tinder.
But it's like,
it's out there.
It's like one person who might follow your wife.
Right.
Yeah.
Like on Instagram sees it because she's single.
It could be anything.
Anyone.
Yeah. Could be a second cousin.
Literally.
You just never know.
Yeah.
And also like, don't cheat.
Yeah.
No. Yeah.
Just don't.
We're all looking at the camera.
Yeah. Okay. So shall we move on to my segment?
Yes.
My segment is not going to be that long because product of the week. I lately have been trying to find like clothes on Amazon.
Oh yeah, you said this.
Yeah. Did I mention it on the podcast or no?
Yeah,
yeah,
that
you did.
You're like working on Amazon.
Did I really?
Yeah, you did last time.
Frick. Are you serious?
Was that your thing?
Because remember I was like, oh, my new thing is scamming Amazon.
Oh, that's true. Well, I found a brand. Did I say the brand that I found?
No.
No.
Okay. So I found a brand. Actually, when we went to Fashion Week, I got a bunch of stuff from Revolve.
Oh yeah.
And one of the brands, like three of the things I got from Revolve were from this brand called Lioness, which I didn't realize at the time that that was the brand name. I thought it was just like, I don't know, the style or something. I don't
sure.
know. On Amazon, I found Lionesses on Amazon and they have like a lot of their clothes and more beyond what they have on Revolve, different colors and stuff. And I think that's my product of the week. They have a really cute like options that, but they're like cute, you know, sometimes on Amazon it's like
or like the materials
is it the same price as like Revolve or is it a little cheaper, a little like
I think it was maybe the same, it might have been a little bit cheaper. It's definitely not like super cheap regardless,
right, yeah.
But yeah,
out of my price range.
Amazon is for the cheap stuff.
Yeah
Well, I mean the reason I want it on Amazon is because I get Amazon credit. Mm-hmm. So I'm like, I need to find stuff to buy through Amazon.
Yeah.
So
wow.
That's my product of the week.
Amazing.
Yep. Thanks. Great.
Cool. Are we going to do our game now?
Wait, what's your segment?
What is my segment? It was, what am I consuming?
But then we said you could change it to mom something, but I don't remember
parenting
what it was.
Tips.
Oh, did we? Okay.
If
well,
you
can choose.
It's whatever you want, I guess. You have, like, the option. But
I kind of like, no offense, I kind of like the consuming thing still.
I'll do the consuming thing, and then I'll just do a little mom thing.
Okay.
Okay, I watched the documentary Into the Fire on Netflix. It's, like, the crime documentary about, it's actually about a girl who was murdered like over 30 years ago, and it literally takes place in like Holland Hamilton area, like where I live.
In Michigan.
I would never watch that.
It's crazy. Scary. It is crazy. Mom watched it, thought it was really good.
Yeah.
Highly recommend. It was 2 episodes and it was like an hour
That's
each.
It, 2 episodes.
Oh, so it's like a movie.
Yeah, it was 2 episodes, an hour each.
Okay. Is it like, do you know if they use actors and actresses or is it the real people?
It's mostly the real people.
Okay.
Like, it's literally crazy. They have the video footage of somebody literally confessing everything in prison. Like, you see a real life, like, serial killer confession. Oh, yeah.
Oh.
You guess you have to watch and find out.
You got to watch it. It's literally insane.
Okay.
One of the best ones I've watched.
Also, The Perfect Couple.
We talked about that last
episode. Are
you
kidding me?
Dude,
how do I not remember anything?
I think you gotta get kicked, bro. You're done.
I think I need to re-listen to the episodes. Also, okay, The Perfect Couple, and I started, not to make this my segment,
yeah, for real.
I started reading Hotel Nantucket, which I recommended to Danielle.
Oh, yeah.
You talked about that last week,
too.
No,
I didn't.
No, she didn't.
I know.
Do not gaslight me right now.
Lexi had a slightly like terrified smile.
Well, it's just because I know I didn't because I just started it.
Yeah, I assumed that was what was going to happen, but I wanted to see if I could get you.
Okay, well, yeah, you got me. And now I'm pissed. I started it by Ellen Hildenbrand. It's a book.
Oh, it's by the same.
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Mm-hmm.
Cool. I'm reading another book right now. I can't remember the name of it, but I'm trying to stick to like spooky stuff for fall.
Oh, okay.
Like thrillers.
Yeah.
I just like that kind of stuff. I think it's
too.
Fun. I love thrillers.
I love a good spook.
I love a good, my guilty pleasure.
Don't do that.
My guilty pleasure is a good like spooky limited series on Netflix. Oh, I wish everything was a limited series.
Right.
Just one really good season.
Mm-hmm.
And then just a little
know what
mom
that is.
A limited series.
No.
Where
what
there's
is
only
that?
One, like there's not like multiple seasons.
Yeah.
It's just like one.
And then
like,
they like take
like
it off.
The Queen's Gambit was a limited series.
Yeah. Because there's no continuation. It's just one story and multiple episodes.
Oh.
Yeah.
Wait, like from Bridgerton?
No.
I guess the Queen's one would be a limited series.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Queen Charlotte.
Interesting.
And then my mom.
I feel like this whole thing is just us teaching Lexi.
I don't watch as much as you guys. I used to be a big like TV girl.
Yeah.
But I
like. Right. You're in school.
You know, it's kind of giving Kourtney Kardashian.
Is it?
Period. You're not better than us because you don't watch TV.
She also doesn't read though. So.
Okay, but I read other things. I just don't read books. Like novels. Like I read like all my
If you say you read articles,
text
you're
messages.
Lying.
Okay, so not articles, thank you. But like for my
Snapchat
homework,
stories.
It's like so much reading that I have to take notes on.
Yeah,
right.
Yeah, yeah.
You know,
okay,
they're like, oh, read 16 pages and take notes. I'm not reading that and then gonna read a book. My brain hurts.
Right.
Okay.
You know?
I was joking about the Kourtney Kardashian thing.
Oh, it's okay. Period. I love her.
But you know the clip where she said that?
Yeah.
And then Chloe's like you're not better than everyone.
Yeah. It's something about internet, isn't it?
She
well,
doesn't
that's
have
another
Wi-Fi.
One. She's like, you can't get a Wi-Fi box out here.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. And then she's like, life is short. Like, it's good to upload a photo and, like, you look hot or something.
Yeah.
Do you know what I'm talking about?
Like,
what
die with
it?
A Snapchat or
yeah,
Snap
yeah,
going
yeah,
through.
Yeah, that's what it is.
She's like, but radiation.
Yeah.
You guys know that?
I do.
Okay, perfect.
They're, like, out on the basketball courts.
Yeah.
Anyway, so apparently we can quote the Kardashians.
I know.
Right, yeah. My last little mom thing is I'm, like, 95% sure that London smiled for the first time today, like, on purpose.
Oh, really? She smiled
not
when
just
I touched
like,
her head the other day.
Well, yeah. Okay.
She but smiled when first time I held her, actually.
You guys.
No, she did.
No, she has. She's been smiling like if she's tooting or like a little like
not
reflex.
You saying two on the pod.
I know,
but I can't.
She, ever since she became a mom, she loves to say two.
Yeah,
she toots all the time.
She
toots.
Has a whole new vocabulary.
Oh,
sorry.
I'm going to teach you something I learned about parenting. I got you. So in case you didn't know
this is one of those things that people talk about, like, oh, I love when people who aren't parents give you parenting tips. Go ahead, Lexi.
Okay, so that felt like a diss, but I'm still going to give my advice. Well, I learned this the other day. Like, one of my friends at work is, like, a nursing school, and basically, like, they really want parents not to, like, this might be a little weird to talk about on the pod, but oh well. So, like, genital areas, not to give, like, fun names to them. Like, you're not supposed to say, like, yes, foo-foo or, like,
I know that.
My yaya. Yep. Like, you're supposed to, like, say the actual, like, like, you know, yep, medical one, because like if you get harassed and go to the police and you're like, yeah, they touched my hoo-hoo, it's like, what is that? Mm-hmm. So anyways, I didn't know that.
I did know that. That's, thank you for sharing that, Lexi.
Yeah, so I'm,
but we
saying,
we do plan on.
Okay, I was just letting you know.
I have,
because yes, if you're teaching them like two, like, bro,
okay, two two is appropriate, because she doesn't fart, she's a baby. She's like eight, not even 8
when
pounds.
Do you graduate from toot to fart?
Yeah,
when you're a teenager.
What?
Okay. Interesting.
Cassidy,
nah,
still toots.
Bro. When you're like 8, you're definitely not tooting.
Okay, so is that your parenting thing is London smiled?
Well, then Lexi cut me off, because and then you cut me off. You're like, oh, she smiled for me last week.
Oh.
No, she, I think she did it on purpose, because I did something and she smiled this morning.
What'd you
and then
do?
I did the same thing again. I was like singing a little song.
Okay.
And then I did the same thing again and she smiled again, like on purpose. And then I did it again and she didn't smile. So I was okay.
But so she could have been passing gas, but she could have liked your smile.
No, she like looked at me in the eyes and like got her whole
I believe
face.
You.
Yeah.
It was so cute. I
but
literally cried.
Isn't it like 6 months?
I believe
months?
You. I thought it was eight
no.
weeks. But that might
oh,
be.
Oh, 8 weeks?
It's yeah. six to 12 weeks.
And what is she?
She's 5.5 weeks.
So she could, because six.
Right.
She'll she's be close. 6 weeks when this comes out, though. So she's
right,
advanced.
But she didn't smile before this came out.
Yeah.
Right.
Right.
You tweaked.
Sorry.
Cute.
That's not how it works. That is cute, though. I hope she really did smile.
Yeah.
No, like I'm
no,
saying.
Yeah,
like
me too. Like gaslighting Danielle. She didn't smile, actually.
I also do.
She physically can't right now, so oh. apparently.
Yeah.
Unless funny. She's advanced. You never know. Like, I started walking into...
Yeah, at 8 months.
I started walking and talking way before you're supposed to.
Did you know you walked before you crawled?
Yeah, mom told me that. Yeah. I was just ready.
She just went right
I was
into
ready,
it.
I was ready to leave.
Oh.
I'm you, kidding. I was ready to catch up with you guys.
I feel like yeah. Lexi was probably a conscious baby.
Probably.
I don't know. Sometimes,
I remember.
Sometimes I looked in those eyes and I was like...
Not a thought behind those eyes.
Okay, she's so just like, walk, gum, walk.
Okay.
Oh,
so don't
we
try
were told
to
the gum
insult
story?
Me as a child. Oh, about how I ate so much gum, I had to have 4 teeth removed.
Yeah. Lexi was obsessed with gum. We had to switch her to sugar-free.
Yeah.
Orbit.
Due to the yeah. dentist request, because that, like, every day when my dad got home from work, he would bring me, like, a new pack of Hubba Bubba. Because I loved Hubba Bubba. Like, it was, I mean, it's delicious. Have you ever had it?
Pieces are so big. Yeah.
Oh, my gosh.
Your
I would,
little mouth.
Oh, I would eat, like, multiple. I had the watermelon, the regular. Oh. I loved them. And so my dad would, like, bring them home because it made me smile, whatever. Like, when I would get in trouble, my mom would, like, there were two punishments, no Hubba Bubba or no talking. Yeah. It was yeah. one or the other. And then finally I went to the dentist once, and, like, I already had silver teeth. Like, I was one of the silver tooth kids, you know, from cavities from my Hubba Bubba. And then it just got bad where it, like, infected the teeth around it. And they're like, okay, like, we have to, like, literally remove your teeth. And you are not allowed to eat Hubba Bubba anymore. And I remember I cried yeah. at the dentist appointment. They said I only could have sugar-free Orbit gum. And I was like, Orbit gum?
Which actually is pretty good stuff.
But not as a
the
child, bro. Like, the it's like a big, like you unwrap it and it has like the purple inside yeah, and like... Yeah.
And it's pretty good. And you can blow really big bubbles.
Exactly.
Yeah. I get that.
But anyways, yeah. so I got banned.
Yeah. We had to start calling gum, like, the Spanish word, the chicle. Because Lexi, if we ever mentioned gum, it was like she was this, I don't know, it was like you were a little puppy.
An animal.
You said the word treat.
My like, favorite animal is Lexi when she hears the word gum.
Dang.
It was crazy.
All right, shall we play?
We yeah. shall play.
Okay. Are you hosting or are we rotating through?
Sure. Oh, or we could rotate, whatever.
So that was not a sure. Like,
right.
sure didn't answer
it's
that.
Okay. She didn't say it into the mic anyway, so no one could hear it.
Sorry.
It's fine.
I was going to look and see if there's like instructions, but there's...
I played this once with friends. They might have taken it out.
Oh.
I mean, are the instructions night. Just like, who knows
yeah,
the answer?
I think it's like a little more complicated
oh.
than,
oh, here
did you
go.
Just toot?
Did the box just toot?
The box tooted. Game rules.
Don't read them out
I'm not
going
to read
mic.
All of them.
Okay. We're going to lose like 90%
everyone
of viewers.
Hits pause or
so
exits out.
You, the score, someone draws a card and they ask the person on your left a question. You can
Danielle,
choose
into
to.
Your, into your mic, please.
Sorry. you can choose to answer it or skip. And if you skip, then you move on to the second question because there's like multiple questions on one card.
Okay.
And so on until all four questions have been asked and a new card is drawn by the person sitting to the scorekeeper's left. Okay. So basically you get one out of four. Like you just have to answer one out of four, correct?
And if I don't get out of any of the four, I think she would be able to steal, right?
Okay.
Oh. Sure. Okay.
I just assume that makes it fun.
Yeah, let's do that.
We'll my do favorite a little animal is when Cassidy, when Danielle doesn't talk into the mic and Cassidy gets mad, or when I spin my chair and Cassidy gets mad.
There's reasons for everything.
I know. It's because she's the technical producer.
She's our sound
engineer.
She's
ready from iCarly.
Oh my gosh, I am.
3, 2, 1. You're literally ready.
But people have made comments about Danielle like not being able to hear. Danielle, I'm 100% sure it's Danielle's fault.
It's so me.
I just want to make sure everyone can hear you.
It's me. Yeah. All right. Are you ready?
Mm-hmm.
So ready. Wait, so Lexi starts.
Correct. I am to the left.
Okay, perfect.
What do you drink if you drink Evian?
What?
Are you serious?
I've never heard that word in my life.
Steal.
Evian? Yeah. No, I get the whole card, I thought. Or, okay, fine. Whatever.
No,
we'll
it's,
do it
she
this
can
way.
Steal the question.
Wait, can you read it again?
What do you drink if you drink Evian?
Aloe.
Steal.
You drink aloe?
Wait, what's that thing that the green stuff in drinks?
Aloe.
Yeah, people, there's aloe drinks.
Wrong.
It's good for you.
Steal.
Yes, Cassidy?
You drink water.
Correct.
Water is H2O.
Lexi, Evian is the brand.
Lexi, like Evian Dasani. Water.
Oh, I've never heard of that.
What are you talking about? It's fancy in the gas stations.
Yeah. I think of Erewhon.
Erewhon, the grocery store.
Okay, anyways, next.
Do you want me to go through the whole card and then maybe like after I go through a card, you take the next card or something?
Sure. Okay. So you have 1 point.
Got it. I'll keep track.
Who is Cassius Marcellus Clay Jr., better known as?
Okay, so these are stupid. These aren't things I should know. I don't know.
This one's hard.
I don't know either. I know.
Harry Potter?
No, I actually thought, Lexi, that's what I thought too.
Really?
We're so
what
wrong.
What about some like Greek mythology creature?
No.
J.K. Rowling.
No. Muhammad Ali.
What?
That feels offensive to not know.
That's crazy.
That feels wrong.
Yeah, I know.
He's a really big character.
Okay, next. What is it called in bowling when all the pins are knocked down during the second attempt?
The second?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so
ooh.
It's either a spare, a turkey. Is that golf? Spare turkey or
I love watching like the gears in Lexi's brain.
Okay, I don't think strike. Oh, it's no, a strike is when you get them all. No, spare is when you get them all. I'm gonna go strike.
Are you being serious, Lexi?
Okay,
Lexi.
I'm gonna go spare.
No,
I don't know. Okay,
it's a spare.
Okay,
wait,
period.
What was the question?
What is it called when all the pins are knocked down during the second attempt?
Oh, I see. I thought it was when you get two strikes. I thought that was the
what is that question.
I don't know. I was going to say a double.
I think that's just called a double. That's just called a double.
Okay, so it's a strike.
So was I right or wrong?
You said strike, so you were wrong.
Yeah, but I said double, which means I'm also wrong.
I took a bowling class in college. So
girl, that's what you don't share on
what do you mean? I got my PE credit in college. I took bowling. Right. It was fun.
Wait, what's PD?
PE. Physical education.
PE in college?
Mm-hmm.
Oh,
something.
I haven't gotten that.
It was so fun. I bowled at 11 a.m.
I don't think I got one either.
Anyways, what is the last name of brothers Liam and Noel in the band Oasis?
Okay.
I
don't know. You should choose cards that the questions are.
I'm not even gonna do. You guys don't know that.
Okay.
See though, like what I did with my friends is we didn't do the whole card if like no one was gonna know it. It was just questions that like maybe we could stump.
Okay.
You know, if it's stupid.
Okay. So. The answer was Gallagher, in case anyone actually wondered. Do you want to move on?
Yeah.
Okay.
So I didn't get a single point.
Yeah.
That's fine.
Cass, you got one?
I did.
Okay.
Oh, this is a good one. So this is for you, Cassidy.
Okay.
What are most of the U.S. gold reserves stored? Where are most of the U.S. gold reserves stored?
Oh. I didn't know we had gold. let me just say... Washington, D.C.?
No. Danielle, do you know?
I don't know the city, but I know that, yeah, I don't know
the city. Is it California?
No.
Okay, cool.
Is it somewhere in Indiana?
I don't know the location of this place. It's not like a city or a state. It's like an actual
location. Is it the embassy?
No.
Okay, go ahead.
Whenever I hear reserve, I just think of the Starbucks reserve.
Same.
Fort Knox, so.
Oh.
Yeah.
I don't know where that is.
Me either. Somewhere where they probably had a war.
Right.
Right. That's usually okay. What fort means.
Yeah. Yeah. Who tops the list of NBA's all-time leading scorer?
Who's the top of the list of all-time leading scorer?
Yeah, basically.
Score?
Mm-hmm.
Steph Curry?
No. Danielle, do you know?
Michael Jordan.
I was going to say, is it Kobe Bryant or Larry Bird?
No.
Who is that?
I actually know this one. It's Kareem Abdul-Jabbar.
Oh.
Yeah.
Man, so. I love my boy Steph. Wish he could be at the top of that list.
He has so many more years. He probably will be.
Because he, like...
Towards the end of... Like, he's...
Yeah.
He has at least, like, 10 more years.
Mm. Okay. How many bones are in the human body?
I used to know this. 158.
Cool. No.
206.
Yes!
Wow.
So you get 1 point.
Yay. Lindsay's screaming at us right now.
I know. Okay, Cassie, this one you should get.
Okay.
What is the process used by plants to convert energy from sunlight to store it in chemical
Photosynthesis.
Bonds? Good job. Yay. Photosynthesis. Okay.
2 points.
Yeah.
Okay, so now it's my turn?
Yeah.
Okay.
Lexi's struggling.
Well, those are just bad. Oh. We already looked at those.
Ooh.
But I only have one hand.
So then these are for me, and then you steal, Lex.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okay. So this is for Danielle. Wait. Okay. I'm literally stumping myself with this question. Does 0 degrees stand for latitude or longitude on the equator?
Latitude.
Latitude.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So she was right.
Yay.
Oh, okay. Cool. Yeah, she was right. Sorry. I'm like processing
confused
this
by the cards.
Everything is confusing to me right now. Okay.
Yeah, like.
All right, Danielle, what 3 colors are on the Irish flag?
Green, white, and orange.
Yes, correct.
Yay.
That's easy. Oh, okay.
Yeah, I was so going to say.
This is points. Also really easy. Tony Hawk is one of the world's most prominent practitioners of what activity?
The word practitioner is crazy.
I know.
Skateboarding.
Yes. Okay, Then lastly, what do people with albinism lack?
Well, they're albino. They lack a melanin, like pigment.
Yes, melanin / pigment.
Yeah.
Awesome. So Danielle just 5 points. Out of the water. Okay, also, I could have gone
that
all
was
those.
Really an easy card.
It was.
That was like...
Now that I know, you'll get more points, Lexi. I just went through the whole card before.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm going to ask you this one because I really think you know it. Because
okay.
I think you're smart.
So, okay. So if I don't get this, I'm dumb. So no pressure.
Actually, no. I'm not going to ask you that question.
Just ask it. It's
what
fine.
Is the Pink Panther that Inspector Clouseau searches for in the film of the same name? What is the Pink Panther?
A diamond?
Yeah, good job.
Oh,
was
period.
That really the question?
Yeah.
Bro, go off.
At first I was like, Jacques
okay,
Clouseau?
Inspector.
Yeah.
Blub.
You okay. love to quote the Pink Panther,
I do,
bro.
Apparently.
That's what Charlie said.
Okay. What state is Duke University located in?
Oof. I have
you
no
know this.
Idea. Is it one of the Carolinas? No, okay, that's a no.
Duke? Where the freak is Duke? I think I've been there.
I haven't.
Oh, wait,
been
no,
there.
That was Princeton.
You've been to Princeton?
Yeah.
Oh.
I went there for 4 years.
Okay.
It's giving Elwoods.
Duke? I actually have no idea, but maybe like Massachusetts.
I was going to say Massachusetts.
The fact that you both were going to say Massachusetts.
Wait,
it's
no,
bad.
No, is she wrong?
Yes.
Wait, no, no. I'm going to say Connecticut.
You guys, North Carolina.
I asked if it was one of the Carolinas.
You're yelling.
Oh,
look at
sorry.
How high your
no,
little voice just went up.
She can't confirm nor deny.
I just looked at you.
Oh, I knew it was. I actually knew that. I was going to say North Carolina, but then I was like, oh, like I'm not because she said no.
You tweaked.
Oh. Dude. Oh, I knew it. I drove past the sign. I'm an idiot.
I think that was the second question, right?
Yeah.
All right.
So I have 1 point.
Mm-hmm. What is the name of the lion cub who is the main character in Disney's animated classic, The Lion King?
Okay, so I really don't know because I only watched this movie once and it made me sad and never watched it again. But I know there's Simba. I think that's it, right? Simba?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Period. There it's a really sad movie.
Yeah, it made me too sad. Like, spoiler, that shouldn't be an animated movie. That should be like, I don't even know, bro.
It is an animated movie.
It's pretty
movie.
Deep. Mm-hmm. A lot of the early Disney movies,
so deep.
Yeah, I'm like, whoa, this is like...
Like, they give you messages.
Traumatizing.
That, okay. This is the last question for you.
Okay.
What ingredient do people with celiac disease have to avoid in their diet?
Well, it's gluten, if you're celiac.
Yep.
So wheat, gluten, yeah.
Gluten, yeah.
Period. Did you know that?
No.
Oh,
and that's period. Actually, I've always wondered about celiac.
I only know that
their body can't process gluten. That's why they get so sick.
Right.
Like your stomach bloats and stuff. I think I only knew that because I'm a cervix. People will be like, so I have a celiac intolerance. And I'm like, okay.
No. It's celiac disease.
Yeah, or whatever. They say that.
Yeah.
And I'm gluten like, okay, intolerance. So gluten. You're gluten free. Okay. What country is the sports apparel and accessory company Adidas from?
I knew you were going to ask about Adidas. Shoot. It is because like it just like the minute you said sports company, I thought Adidas.
Oh, okay.
Okay. So it's definitely somewhere in Europe. I'm going to say Adidas.
Okay.
Adidas. Where is that?
I
want to
steal. I want to steal.
Adidas. Germany.
Good job.
That was mine.
Hey, let's go.
Okay.
Period.
I'm locked in.
Okay. What is the only U.S. state that ends in the letter G?
G?
Sing the song.
Shut up. What ends with G? G? Wyoming.
Good job.
Yep. Wow.
What actress played Vivian in the 1990 film Pretty Woman?
I've never seen that.
Oh, I love that movie. I asked that because I love that movie, so I thought you'd seen it. It's Julia Roberts.
Oh,
that,
well, I was gonna steal.
Sorry. You looked at me like, I'm sorry. I don't know why I keep reading your looks, but you looked at me like you didn't know.
I literally was about to say
Julia
Roberts.
I believe you
know
it because you told me to watch it, so you can get a point.
Thank you.
Oh.
What was Victoria Beckham's nickname when she was a part of the girl group Spice Girls?
Oh,
I asked you this because you're old.
I literally did. I literally last month Googled all the names of the Spice Girls because I had no idea. She was.
Love being Gen Z.
I can't remember it.
Okay, so they're Sport Spice. She's not Sport Spice. Isn't she like. I don't know.
You don't know.
It was
know.
Something
you
like.
Give up.
It was something like fashion-y. I can't remember.
Is it like Cute Spice?
Pop.
Cutie
I can't remember.
Spice
Not pop.
Rooney?
Okay, so you're all wrong. It's Posh Spice.
Posh Spice.
You're low-key close. How many questions did I ask you?
I
think this was her third.
Yeah, I think I get one more.
Okay. I feel like these are low-key hard. What does an alchemist try to create?
Alchemy? I don't know what an alchemist is other than Taylor Swift's song, The Alchemy.
Oh, period.
Okay, wait, let me think. Chemistry.
It definitely has something to do with that.
Science, molecules.
Okay, so I'm going to stop you there. It's gold.
Oh.
But
oh my gosh, wait, I want to be an alchemist.
Okay.
There you go. Okay, my turn.
I can take
also,
it.
I love the song, The Alchemy.
Yeah, it is really good. I wonder if that has something to do with gold.
Right? Now I'm going to listen to it with a new perspective.
Yeah.
Okay, Danielle, who was America's second president?
John Adams.
Correct.
You're so annoying.
Also, I hate you.
Like, who the heck knows that?
I'm just going to ask you every question and hope that you know it because you're just so good at this game. I'm just kidding.
I also play, I've like played a lot of trivia, like at bars. So okay. I like.
What is the capital of Finland?
I don't know. Finn City?
No.
Oh, Lexi, you're going to steal?
Lexi Finland. With the steal.
It's not Poland. So I don't know.
You don't even know the capital of Poland.
Poland is a country.
I know.
Okay. So it's Helsinki?
Cassidy.
For some reason, I have like a deep-rooted connection with Finland because when I was in fifth grade, we had to like track the World Olympics, and I got assigned Finland. So I had to like watch all the games, and I was like a big Finland. Like, do you know the flag colors?
No,
I do. Blue and white.
Mm. Okay, Danielle, what is
love the Finland.
What is considered a full house in poker?
In poker, it's like two face cards. It's a 2 and 3 combo.
Okay, yeah, three of a kind together with a pair.
Yeah.
Okay.
I would have known that.
Let's see. What kind of nuts are used in a Waldorf salad?
You know this?
Yes.
In a Waldorf salad?
Yep. Hee-hee-hee-hee-hee.
Walnuts.
Yeah.
So annoying.
That's a lucky guess.
That was a lucky guess. I mean, we just have a Waldorf chicken wrap at my work.
Oh.
So. Oh, okay.
I just thought it probably can't be pine nuts because too many people have allergies to them.
Wow, you really thought that pretty fast.
I don't know, almonds.
I just thought, what would Blair Waldorf want in a salad?
Well, yeah. Definitely walnuts. Then I thought walnuts.
Yeah, and pecans are like too sweet.
I love
Is it pecan or pecan?
Pecan.
I don't know, dude. Mm. Is it orange or is it orange?
Definitely not orange.
You know how many people say orange?
Is it pink or is it pink?
Okay. So we're not answering that question.
Okay. So these are for Lexi.
Is it caramel or is it caramel?
Sorry. Is it almond or almond?
Mm. Is it when or is it when? That's what. That's what people I know that are older do.
Lexi, do people's pupils get larger or smaller in bright light?
Crap. Okay, so I've had 6 concussions. Let me think of the test. In bright light, they dilate, so they get smaller.
Yeah.
Yes.
They don't dilate though.
Oh, whatever.
They expand.
No, they get smaller. Which means dilation is wider. That's why you have to wear sunglasses when you get dilated because your pupils are too big.
For if it's sunny outside.
Whatever, my brain figured it out. So,
what is the world's largest retailer?
Retailer?
Mm-hmm. Could you be a little bit more specific?
No, that's what the question says.
Like retailer? Like what does that mean? Like retail is like anything.
You should know this.
Shops? Like company, like clothes?
Like a store. Like a brand. What's the largest retailer?
Walmart.
Yep.
Wow.
Okay. That was She's the luckiest locked. Guess of my life.
Literally.
Was that your second question?
Yeah.
Okay. Russia is the largest country in the world in terms of area. What country is the second largest?
In terms of area.
Country? So a country.
Right.
I mean, I feel like America is really freaking big.
That's what every American thinks.
Cassidy has buzzed in for a steal.
Okay, Canada's huge. It's not Mexico. None of it's that. Is it Mexico? You guys are laughing.
Is that your final
answer? No. Oh. It's none of the South America countries. They're all mad small. I don't know. China isn't that huge.
I love that Lexi thinks out loud.
Africa...
is a continent.
Boo-boo. Yeah, I know. I'm thinking of the countries in it. Boo-boo.
Okay.
All right, dude. Final answer. China.
Canada.
I locked in for a steal. I was going to say Canada.
You get the point then. I'm sorry. You. I pulled Alexi.
Thank you.
Dude, I knew it was Canada. It's huge.
Okay. You'll know this one. Huge.
It's huge. That was Pink Panther. That wasn't.
No, I thought that's Donald Trump. I have like it's huge.
He does.
Yeah, but then Cassie said idiot.
Oh yeah.
No, I didn't.
No, she didn't.
Oh, I'm hearing things.
Sorry. It's okay.
Okay. So you have 2 more questions.
Mm-hmm.
Who is the founding father of psychoanalysis?
Next.
Lexi,
next.
You know next. This.
Of psychoanalysis.
You know.
Wait,
this.
The founding father of psychoanalysis.
Is it a president? Like founding father president?
No, Cassidy.
Like founding father is just a term.
Who founded psychoanalysis?
It's that one guy. I know his name. Everyone's like, oh, like this. I just can't think of it right now. I took a psych class. It's Freud.
Yes.
Period.
I knew you knew it. See?
Okay.
Okay. I don't think you'll know this one.
Isn't it Sigmund Freud?
Well, I can look for a different question.
One more question.
What brand is that behind the iconic perfume number 5?
Chanel.
Good job.
Good job.
So okay. I actually devoured. I don't even care the score. I win. Honestly, I think after that, Walmart, be for real.
I feel like...
Be for real.
I didn't play to my full potential.
Oh, interesting. Yeah.
So I know you're in last, but...
Oh.
It's definitely between perfect. Me and Danielle.
I would probably say Danielle won. She got like every single question right.
You get... Okay. Okay. That seems a little
we have
biased.
Time. We this can do two more questions round. For me.
Yeah. Okay.
I might have put the other ones back on top by accident.
When you address a letter with C/O, what do the C and O stand for? I thought you'd know this because you're a business owner.
Lexi, what? You I don't write letters.
Well, maybe you should.
Maybe you should. I'm pick a good question for me. Owner. Pick what? A good, skip this question. You write letters? Who the freak writes letters? Lazy. Oh, now I'm just mad. Now okay. I'm mad.
Fine, I'll ask you an easy one, little baby. What is the round button on the iPhone called? Cassidy.
A button?
The round button on an iPhone. It's a little outdated. I'll give you that.
Home button.
Yes.
What in the world?
The final question.
Yeah, I'm going to get a good one. Oh, this is what you just asked me.
Maybe go through
that's
the middle.
That's way too easy. You... Dude, this is the same card you just asked.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Danielle pull from the middle. Said. Here, pull one of these. Oh.
What?
Okay.
Okay, Cassidy. What is the name of Australia's largest airline?
Lexi.
She's a traveler.
Lexi, has she been to Australia?
She's probably wanted to. Okay, I can do a different one.
Lexi, don't do one of these because I picked up that card.
Kangaroo Air.
Okay. Cassidy.
It's actually, isn't Kangaroo Air something?
Koala Air. I know.
No, it was like Qualis Air or something.
Sure.
Qantas Airways. Whatever.
So nothing,
my fault,
yeah.
Dude. Okay. No, you're not going to know that. Dude, I think
just
you're doomed.
Just pick
Cassidy.
One. Just pick one.
What's the largest planet in our solar system?
Oh, Jupiter.
Period. Okay. Mm-hmm.
Thank you. And with that, okay. We're ending our episode on a high note. We love to end things on a high note.
We do.
We're not at all mad at each other.
No. Yeah. I'm definitely not going to need to take five before we record again. Thank you guys so much for listening to today's episode. Hope you liked it. Hope you watch on YouTube because everything's better on YouTube.
It's true.
We'll see you next week for another episode.
Bye. Bye.